No les di un para que pusieran aquí arriba. But I want to talk to you about the giant of discouragement. El gigante de el desánimo. Do you know that this is one of the biggest giants that is coming against the church and is coming against the world in general? Este es uno de los gigantes más grandes que está viniendo en contra de la iglesia, pero también está viniendo en contra del mundo. Discouragement is universal. El desánimo es universal. Meaning, in Japan, there's people that are being discouraged right as we speak. En Japón, hay gente que se está desanimando. Hay gente que se está desanimando en México. They're discouraged. There's people that are discouraged in Mexico. Anywhere you go, this giant is coming against the churches. This giant is coming against the world. This giant is coming against political leaders. It's coming against presidents. Está viniendo en contra de líderes políticos, en contra de presidentes. Este gigante de el desánimo. Do you know that the giant of discouragement came to a lot of people in the Bible as well? El gigante del desánimo, mi hermano, vino a mucha gente, muchos hombres y mujeres de Dios en la Biblia. David, a mighty king, David, un rey, aleluya, tremendo, vino a ser desanimado. He was discouraged. Jeremiah was discouraged. Jeremías estaba, se desanimó. Elías, se desanimó. Jesus, at one point, Jesús, en un tiempo también, aleluya, se desanimó por la gente, como la gente no le respondía. People would not respond to his teachings, a la enseñanza de él. And discouragement takes on many forms in our life. El desánimo viene y toma muchas formas en nuestra vida. There's people right now that are not here today because they're discouraged. Hay gente que no está aquí en este día porque se desanimaron. One way or another, they got discouraged. Discouragement comes in your family. El desánimo viene a tu familia. Probably in a marriage, quizás en un matrimonio. Maybe in your house with your children, quizás en tu casa con tus hijos. Maybe through finances, a través de las finanzas, you get discouraged. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
There's a battle, amen, that is coming against the family. There's a battle that is coming against the churches. Hay una batalla, una pelea que viene en contra de la familia, de los hijos. Y esa pelea, esa batalla es con el gigante del desánimo. The giant of discouragement. Can I get an amen? There's wives right now that are discouraged because their husband don't want to come to church. Hay esposas que están desanimadas porque sus esposos no quieren venir a la iglesia. There's husbands that are discouraged because their wives don't want to come to church. Hay esposos que están desanimados porque las esposas no quieren venir a la iglesia. Come on, somebody. And sometimes the wife gets tired of being the head, or sometimes the husband gets tired of pulling when the wife doesn't want to, or the wife pulling when the husband doesn't want to. A veces se cansa la esposa porque está estirando y el esposo no quiere. O sea, el esposo se cansa porque el esposo está estirando y la esposa no quiere. There's many ways that discouragement will come in, and when it comes in and it takes a hold of the family or the house, the husband and the wife, it'll take on the whole family. Cuando el desánimo viene y agarra o toma al esposo o a la esposa, mi hermano, toma toda la familia. Because discouragement is contagious. El desánimo es contagioso. When you are discouraged, the first thing you do is you tell people why you are discouraged. And then you make them see through your eyes. Are you here today? Si tú estás desanimado, lo primero que haces, mi hermano, le vas y le cuentas a alguien por qué estás desanimado tú, y empiezas a hacerlos a ellos que miren a través de tus ojos. So because something happened in your life because you're discouraged, porque tú estás desanimado, you want everybody else to be discouraged with you. Porque tú estás desanimado, tú quieres que todos los demás estén desanimados contigo. ¿Cuántos dicen amén? So pastors get discouraged. Preachers get discouraged. Pastores se desaniman a veces. Pastors get discouraged because they preach the word and people still don't get the word. Los pastores se frustran o se desaniman a veces porque predicamos la palabra y la gente no la agarra la palabra. ¿Cuántos dicen amén? So we get discouraged because we're here, we're preaching on Wednesdays and we preach on Sundays. You know why we stopped on Monday classes? Because pastor got discouraged because nobody would show up, so we closed it. ¿Sabe por qué no tenemos la clase los lunes del matrimonio? Porque el pastor se desanimó, porque nadie venía a la clase y lo cerramos. Because we come to help you. Venimos a ayudarte a ti, mi hermano. The teachings are to help you. Las enseñanzas son para ayudarte. Because everybody's holy in here. But what happens when you walk outside? Todos son santos aquí. Aquí todo te va bien aquí dentro de la iglesia. Pero ¿qué sucede cuando sales allá afuera? When you come to the real challenges. What happens when you go to your job? And you're supposed to get that position and then give it to somebody else. What happens? What do? You get discouraged. When you work and you work and you work and they give it to somebody else who you think is lazy and does not have the potential that you have or have the skills that you have, but they give it to somebody else, you get discouraged, and a lot of times you get discouraged and you quit. Right? Muchas veces nos desanimamos cuando le dan la posición a alguien más en vez de que nos la den a nosotros y se la da a una persona que no sabe trabajar o que no tiene el ánimo que nosotros o no sabe lo que nosotros sabemos, se lo dan a alguien más y nos desanimamos y a veces hasta dejamos el trabajo. Can I tell you what the enemy does to Christians? ¿Sabe qué es lo que hace el enemigo a los cristianos? When the enemy comes in and discourages a Christian, you know what the first thing they do? Is they stop coming to church. They stop talking to God. Cuando el desánimo viene en contra de los cristianos lo primero que hacen es dejan de venir a la iglesia y dejan de hablar con Dios. Can I tell you something? God did not do anything to you. Dios no te hizo nada. God didn't get you discouraged. Dios no te desanimó. So why did you stop talking to him? ¿Por qué dejaste de hablar con él? God didn't discourage you, so why did you come to his house? Why did you stop coming to his house? Dios no te desanimó. ¿Por qué dejaste de venir a su casa? Help me some. Y'all are quiet today. Amen. When this discouragement is a very a powerful giant, if we let him come into our house. There's households, there's pastors that are in a house that stopped preaching or closed down churches because they got discouraged with people. Hay pastores, predicadores, que cerraron iglesias porque se desanimaron con la gente.
Amen.
There's pastors that they didn't believe God enough that, you know what, if they don't want to, God's going to bring some people that will. I preach to hundreds of people, and I preach to through two or three people. I preach the same way, whether I have 20 and I have one. Because I do it unto Him. Yo predico igual si tengo uno o tengo 20. ¿Por qué? Porque lo hago para Dios. But so many people have been discouraged. Ezra was one of the ones that was discouraged. Ezra, una persona que se desanimó cuando estaban tratando de construir el templo. They were trying to rebuild the temple. He got discouraged because of how he saw the city, como había visto la ciudad, todas las ruinas, y se desanimó. But what I want to talk to you about today, I want to talk to you about Elijah. Te quiero hablar de Elías. Elías era un profeta tremendo de Dios. Let me tell you something. Elijah did 16 powerful miracles. Elías hizo 16 milagros poderosos. Powerful miracles that Elijah did, listen, before confronting Jezebel. Antes de confrontar a Jezabel, Elías hizo 16 milagros poderosos. Three times he got fed. Tres veces se le dio de comer. He got fed by the ravens. He got fed by a widow. And he got fed by an angel. Una ave le vino y le dio de comer. Un ángel vino y le dio de comer. Una viuda le vino y le dio de comer. Profeta poderoso de Dios. And you find those miracles in 1 Kings. En Primera de Reyes usted ve esos milagros. In 1 Kings chapter 17 verse 1 you see the miracle of the drought. Usted ve el milagro, aleluya, de la sequedad, aleluya. En Primera de Reyes 17:1 es cuando Dios lo usó y dijo, ya no va a llover. There's not going to be no rain. ¿Cuántos dicen amén? En Primera de Reyes 17:14 fue cuando él, aleluya, hizo el milagro de la comida y del aceite. That's what he did. In 1 Kings chapter 17, verse 14, that's when he multiplied the meal, the oil, in the widow's house. Cuando él multiplicó. Poderoso. Powerful. Can I give him it? In 1722 is when he restored a child back to life. And in 17, capítulo 17, 22, de Primera de Reyes, es cuando trajo vida a aquel niño que estaba muerto. Powerful man of God. Hombre poderoso de Dios. In chapter 18, verse 38, is when he called fire from heaven and it consumed the sacrifice. En capítulo 18, versículo 36 de Primera de Reyes, es cuando llamó fuego del cielo y consumió todo el sacrificio. Aleluya. In 1841 is when he called the drought to stop. Powerful man of God. Hombre poderoso de Dios, usado tremendamente. He was powerful. He destroyed 400 prophets. 400 profetas los destruyó. Hombre poderoso de Dios. He's a very powerful man of God.
Señor.
I mean, he was just taking everything by storm. Él venía, llegaba, aleluya, y todo, aleluya, lo destruía. Yeah. Venía con la palabra de Dios. He was coming with the word of God. Then we come to chapter 19 of 1 Kings, Primera de Reyes, capítulo 19, and then we come to the verse 1, and it says, now Ahab told Jezebel everything that Elijah had done and how he had killed all the prophets with the sword. Acab vino y le dijo a Jezabel todo lo que estaba haciendo Elías y cómo había matado los profetas con una espada. Great man of God. Nombre tremendo de Dios. Amen. Doing all these great miracles. Son milagros tremendos. I don't know what it is about a woman, but her words have power. Yo no sé qué hay de una mujer, pero las palabras de una mujer son poderosas. Some of you are bound by the words of your wife.
That's right.
Muchos de ustedes están atadas por las palabras de su esposa. I mean, your wife tells you something, you don't say how high, you just jump. Tu esposa te dice que brinque, tú no dices qué alto, que no, tú nomás brincas hasta que te diga párale. So, you find Elijah doing all these great miracles, Elías haciendo estos grandes milagros. And then verse 2, something happens. Versículo 2 del 19, verse 2 of chapter 19 said, so Jezebel sent a messenger. She didn't even go herself. How powerful her words are. Tan poderosa la palabra de Jezabel que no fue ella. Ella mandó a un mensajero. She sent a messenger. So Jezebel sent a messenger to who? To Elijah, saying, may the gods punish me and do so severely if I don't make your life like the life of one of them by this time tomorrow. Put it in Spanish. Mira lo que dijo Jezabel. Entonces envió Jezabel a Elías un mensajero, no fue ella, mandó a alguien, diciendo, así me hagan los dioses y así me añadan. Dice, si mañana a estas horas yo no haya puesto tu persona como la de uno de ellos.
Mm.
She didn't go, but she sent somebody over there. Ella no fue, pero ella mandó a alguien. You see how powerful these words are, esas palabras? I mean, he had just barely done so many miracles, tantos milagros que había hecho este hombre. But he had never confronted a woman. No había confrontado a una mujer. I believe that he probably just heard of her. Never had met her. Yo pienso que él nomás había escuchado de ella y nunca la había conocido. Verse 3. Very powerful. Número 3. Then Elijah became afraid or discouraged, and immediately, what did he do? He ran for his life. When he came to Beersheba, that belonged to Judea, he left his servant there. In other words, he said, hey, you stay here, I'm gone, I'll see you later. His helper, he left it. Sometimes, when you are discouraged, you leave everybody away because you just want to be. See, discouragement isolates you and it puts you in an island all by yourself. El desánimo te aísla. Y te deja solo en una isla, tú solo. Y deja, and you stop communicating, you stop talking to everybody.
Yeah, right.
Deja de hablar con todas las personas. Come on, somebody. We're talking about the giant of discouragement. Estamos hablando del gigante del desánimo. He told the servant, listen, this is what he told the servant. In other words, he said, you do whatever you want, I'm out of here. Es lo que le dijo el siervo de él. ¿Sabes qué? Haz lo que tú quieras, pero yo me voy más adelante. You might not be afraid of him, but I'm afraid of her. So I'm heading out. Can I get an amen? So, it says that he left, se fue, dejó al criado ahí. Now verse 4. We're talking about Elijah. Estamos hablando de Elías, un profeta tremendo de Dios. Amen. But he went on a day's journey into the wilderness. He sat down on, under a broom tree and prayed that he might die. I don't want her to kill me. Why don't you just kill me, God? So that way they can say that you killed me, not a woman.
Yep.
What'd you say, coward?
Yep.
Yeah, he's a coward. He's running. Corriendo. He prayed that he might die. He said, I have had enough. In other words, I am discouraged. I had enough.
Take my life.
Lord, take my life, for I am no better than my father's. Wow. Mira, mira lo que dice. Y él se fue por el desierto un día de camino y vino y se sentó debajo de un enebro y deseando morirse dijo, basta ya. Oh, Jehová, quítame mi alma. Con otras palabras, quítame la vida ya. Mátame. Que no soy yo mejor que mis padres. Discouragement came into his life. El desánimo vino a su vida. Vino a su vida el desánimo. How many of you, God has used you. God has done things through you. God has used you to speak to people, and one little bad thing, you get discouraged and you leave the church. ¿Cuántas veces Dios no te ha usado a ti para hablarle a alguien, para orar por alguien y que reciba un milagro? Y Dios te está usando, y algo viene, una palabra viene y te desanimas y te vas de la iglesia. ¿Cuántas personas?
Sí.
You know why these seats are not filled? Because people are at home discouraged. ¿Sabes por qué estos asientos no están llenos? Es porque la gente está desanimada en su casa. You know what people say? I ain't going to that church because there's a bunch of hypocrites. Can I tell you something? There's hypocrites in the world. Why don't you leave the world too? La gente dice, hay hipócritas ahí en esa iglesia, ya no voy a ir. Hay hipócritas en el mundo, ¿por qué no te sales del mundo? Everywhere you go, there's hypocrites. There's hypocrites at your job. Hay hipócritas en tu trabajo. Why don't you leave it? Because they pay real good, pastor. Pagan bien, pastor. Help me, somebody. Ayúdame a alguien. So the thing is that discouragement causes you to make excuses. El desánimo causa que empieces a poner excusas. Empieza a poner excusas para todo. You begin to put excuses for everything. And you know what? God will not put up with excuses. Right. Dios no va a jugar con esas excusas. Él no está ahí para excusas. As a matter of fact, God is not into your pity party. Dios no está ahí para que te sientas todo de, ay, pobrecito. Dios no dice, ay, pobrecito, mi hijo, mira que te anda desanimado, mi hijo está desanimado. Look, my son, he's discouraged. Oh, poor baby. You know when he came to Joshua? Cuando vino a Josué, que estaba llorando, he was crying because of Moses had died. Había muerto. He said, hey, you're crying?
Yeah.
Are you still crying? Yeah, 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 déjate llorar. Yeah, okay, now get up because there's people waiting for you to stop your pity party. And you need to cross over. Es lo que le dijo Dios. Ya dejaste llorar. Ya tuviste todo. Okay. Hay gente que te está esperando que te levantes porque tienes que cruzar al otro lado a la tierra prometida. There's people that are waiting for you that are never going to come in here until you stop your pity party and stop crying. There's people that need to stop crying at home and get to church because there's people waiting for them, hallelujah, to come to church. Hay gente que los está esperando para venir a la iglesia, pero no van a llegar hasta que no dejes de llorar.
Yeah, that's right.
Come on, somebody help me out here. There's people that don't come to church because they can't handle the word. They want somebody that come in here and just begin to rub on their back. We're not a massage, I'm not a massage therapist, so I'm not going to be rubbing your back. If I'm rubbing somebody back, it'll be my wife. But I'm not a massage therapist. I ain't gonna come and rub it. I'm gonna give you what it says. Te voy a dar lo que la palabra de Dios dice.
Amen. Amen.
Can I get an amen? Because the word will set you free, not the massage.
Amen.
La palabra te va a hacer libre, no el masaje. Can I get an amen, somebody?
Amen.
So, powerful man of God, Elijah. He's very powerful. I mean, I in certain ways I want to be like him, not a coward and run, but in certain ways I want to be like him, just walking in that authority and, you know, look at the sun and say stop.
Yeah.
How many of y'all, you know, when there was all this rain, could have gone outside and say, hey, not here, not in my house, so you're going to go around.
Because
we have the power to speak to the rain. You have the power to speak to the clouds. You have the power to speak to the sun. Tienes poder de hablarle la lluvia, de hablarle al sol, de hablarle, decirle lluvia, ahora no vas a tocar mi casa.
Amen.
Acabo de lavar mi carro, ¿qué tienes? You have to wash my car. What's wrong with you? You got to come and dirty my car. That's how powerful Elijah was. Tan poderoso. ¿Qué era Elías? So now he's under a tree and he just cries, and you know, this is a tree right here. Let's pretend this is a tree. Vamos a pretender que este es el árbol. Amen?
Yeah.
So this is a tree right here. Y viene, hermano. Siéntese aquí abajo, así como que pobrecito, así muy pobrecito. Así como entró la menina. Así muy pobrecito. Así como cara de, así, ya sabes. You know, he's all depressed, está depresionada, he's discouraged, está desanimado, and you know, has the enemy ever made you think twice about what God said about you?
Yeah.
Has the enemy really came against you and said, you're not really called? All of that was just for show. That's how he felt. Así se sentía él. He felt all down and all discouraged. And he was there crying. Estaba llorando ahí. Pretend like you're crying, brother. I know you're not crying, pero como te llora. Como cuando lo regañan en la casa. Como cuando lo regañan en la casa. No saca la guitarra, man. So he was there crying out to God. Llorándole a Dios. Kill me! Mátame, Dios, mátame! You know that God could have came in and struck him dead. Right? God, because God had the power. You know what God came to do? ¿Se sabe lo que vino a hacer Dios? Hallelujah. ¿Estoy llorando? Estoy esperando que llore. I'm waiting for him to cry. Ándale. ¿Cómo cuando le pegan? Ándale. Kill me, mátame. Kill me, Lord, kill me. The Lord didn't come and say, ay, pobrecito Juanito quiere morirse, Juanito. John, he wants to die. Brother Juan wants to die. Send me a like. God didn't come and say, angels, what do you think? Should I kill him? Should I just lo mato. Dios nunca no vino con los ángeles. Dijo, ángeles, ¿qué piensas? Lo matamos, no lo traemos ya. You know what God said? Bible says that in all his bitterness and crying and discouragement, ¿sabe qué hizo él? Se durmió. Se quedó bien dormido, asleep. That's what discouragement brings, depression. El desánimo viene a traer depresión. De tanto que estaba desanimado, cayó en depresión y cayó dormido. You know what God did? ¿Usted sabe qué es lo que hizo Dios? Hey! What are you doing here? That's what God did. Dios no le dijo a sobar la espalda y dijo, hey! ¿Qué estás haciendo aquí? What are you doing here? So, he started telling God what God already knew. Él empezó a decir, Elías empezó a decir a Dios lo que Dios ya sabía. Hey, ¿qué estás haciendo aquí? Didn't you just call fire from heaven? Didn't you just kill 400 prophets?
Yeah.
Didn't you just feed the widow and there's oil still probably running right now?
Yeah.
What are you doing here crying under a tree? ¿Por qué estás aquí llorando? ¿Acaso no hablaste fuego del cielo? ¿Acaso no le fuiste y le dije ahorita el aceite todavía está corriendo en la casa de la viuda? ¿Y ahora estás aquí llorando? ¿Qué estás haciendo? God's not going to come in and join your party. Dios no va a venir a estar contigo aquí en la fiesta. No. Why? Because time is very precious.
Amen.
El tiempo es muy precioso. He's going to tell him something very important. He says, you know what? I'm going to feed you here.
Yeah.
But you're going to get up.
Yeah.
Te voy a dar de comer aquí donde estás. Todo desanimado. Pero te vas a levantar.
Yeah.
Te vas a levantar. You know why you're going to get up? Come here, Pastor. I want you to be right there like you plow in the land. Yeah, it's kind of like. Como te vas con los burros. Lo miró, ¿verdad? ¿O quién lo miró? Yo. Oh, I'm sorry, bro. Cuando dije burro. No, hombre. Una broma en serio. Una broma en serio. No lo tomo. So, Dios le dice: te voy a dar de comer y te vas a levantar. Porque ahí está alguien que te necesita. Somebody over there on the other side needs you. Está trabajando duro, pero ahorita no se mira que está. He's working hard, but he don't look like it right now. But he's working hard. In the middle of your pity party, God says, I'm a beat you. Te voy a dar de comer. But you gotta get up from here. Te tienes que levantar. Because you can't stay here. You are too powerful to be under a tree crying.
That's right.
Amen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Estás tan poderoso para estar bajo de un árbol llorando. Because a woman said that she was going to kill you. Porque una mujer dijo que te iba a matar. How many times have people said they're going to kill you? Get up. Levántate. And when he got up, levántate. Te voy a ayudar porque está pesadito, hermano. When you get up, the one that I'm going to send you to, al que te voy a mandar, he's going to do twice as many miracles as you are. So if you did 16, he's going to do 32. ¿Usted sabe que Eliseo hizo 32 milagros? Elisha did 32 miracles. That means he did twice as much as his successor. It's the one that came in and got him. Jesus said, you know what Jesus said? Jesus could have said, I did 100 miracles, but you're going to do 200. Jesús dijo, yo hice 100, ustedes van a hacer 200. He said, greater things will you do. Mayores cosas ustedes van a hacer. But you know what? The people would have never gotten into the promised land had Joshua stayed crying still. For Moses. Something that was already dead. So God told Elijah to get up and go. And when he came to where Elijah was from, he didn't even say a word. He was just walking, took off his mantle, and he just threw it on him. That's all he did. Le tiró el manto, Eliseo. And he let go of what he had, and he followed him y lo siguió. Are you seeing this? ¿Usted sigue? One of the greatest prophets in the Bible got discouraged. After, listen, just because we come to church, just because we preach the word, just because you're an anointed man or woman of God doesn't mean that you're exempt from discouragement. Solamente porque eres un hombre, una mujer, ungido de Dios, un predicador, un pastor, eso no quiere decir que te descalifica de ser desanimado. Every one of us gets discouraged. Every one of us has been discouraged at one point, one moment in our life. Cada uno de nosotros hemos sido desanimados. What do? Do we stay there? Do we cry? Do we sit and cry?
No.
Do we mourn the loss and just stay there? No, te quedamos ahí, a llorar, allá abajo en el árbol. Or do we get up?
Yeah.
See, God didn't put up with Elijah's cry. Jesus didn't put up. And I wrote it down right here because I want. In John chapter 6, if you can put it up there. John 6, 66 and 67. Look at this. Mira esto. The people could not handle Jesus' teaching. La gente, el pueblo de Dios, no podía con la predicación de Jesús. Mira. From that moment, many of his disciples turned back and no longer accompanied him. In other words, they no longer followed Jesus. They got discouraged and they left. And then here comes Peter, verse 67. Viene Pedro. What does he say? Peter says, therefore Jesus said to the 12, Peter said, Master, everybody's leaving. Like there's people in the church, they come and tell us, there's not a lot of people coming. What's going on? Well, let's trace back the relationship with God. Pastor, mucha gente no está viniendo a la iglesia. ¿Por qué? ¿Qué está pasando? Vamos a ver cómo está la relación de ellos con Dios. So Peter comes back and says, Jesus, everybody's leaving. You know what Jesus said? Hey, you want to go too? Señor, maestro, todos están yendo. Dijo Jesús, ¿te quieres ir tú también? You want to leave? You can leave. And Peter goes, where can we go? You're the one that has the bread of life. What I need, you have. I can't leave you. If I get disconnected from you, I might as well die. En otras palabras, lo que le dijo Pedro a Jesús, ¿para dónde vamos si tú tienes palabra de vida? Lo que yo necesito para sobrevivir está en ti, y si yo me desconecto de ti, yo me muero. We have a lot of dead Christians because they've been disconnected from the bread. Hay muchos cristianos muertos espiritualmente porque se han desconectado de la palabra. They disconnected themselves from the thing that gives them life. Se han desconectado de aquello de que les ha dado vida. Pastor, so what do I do when I get discouraged? Get back up.
Yeah.
Pastor, ¿qué hago cuando me desanimo? Levántate. Get up. And you know what? Get up and do what God called you to do. Yeah. Levántate y haz lo que tienes. When God woke him up and got him up, you know what he did? He continued to do miracles. Because when he got up from here, he spoke to Elijah. You know what he did? He parted the Red Sea. Cuando él estaba aquí, cuando tú estás desanimado, levántate y sigue haciendo el trabajo de Dios. Cuando Dios levantó a Eliseo, a Elías, ¿sabes qué hizo Elías? Fue, trajo a Eliseo y luego hizo otro milagro cuando abrió el partió el mar y caminó hacia el otro lado. What do I do when I get discouraged? Get back up and do what God called you to do. ¿Qué es lo que hago? ¿Sabes qué es lo que hizo Ezra? You know what Ezra did when he got discouraged? He got up and he continued to rebuild. Dice, yo no voy a, no, no, vamos a, no nos vamos a desanimar, dijo Ezra. Aquí vamos a poner, tú te vas a poner allá, vamos a trabajar, we're going to rebuild the temple. Vamos a reconstruir otra vez todo. No nos vamos a desanimar. The work of the Lord has to continue. El trabajo de Dios tiene que continuar. Levántate. I'm here to tell you today, get up and do what God called you to do. Levántate y haz lo que Dios te dijo que hagas. Just because you fall into discouragement doesn't mean that that cancels the calling on your life. Amen. You are still responsible for the calling in your life. Solamente porque caes en un desánimo, eso no cancela el llamado de Dios en tu vida. Como quiera, tienes que dar cuentas a Dios por ese llamado. So if I were you, I better get up and I better do what God called me to do. Vale más que me levante y haga lo que Dios me quiere que yo haga. Come on, somebody. You're discouraged? Get back up. Get back up. How long are you going to be? ¿Qué tanto vas a durar ahí, Josué? ¿Llorando? ¿Ya acabaste? Levántate. Quick. God was quick. How long, Joshua, are you going to be there crying? I'm done. Okay, 3 days I'm going to give you. Get over to the other side. 3 days, God. Hombre, mira. 3 days I want you on the other side. ¿Verdad? ¿Cuánto, Josué? ¿Cuánto? ¿Ya acabaste de orar? Sí. Ok, 3 días te quieren en la tierra prometida. Rápido. We got time to waste. You know why? People are dying out there. La gente está muriendo. Your family is dying without Christ outside of these four walls. Tu familia está muriendo sin Cristo fuera de estas cuatro paredes. What are we doing to prevent that? ¿Qué es lo que estamos haciendo nosotros para prevenir eso? Pastor, they don't listen. You listen. And you listen to what he says. And that's all that matters. You give account to God for your actions, not their actions. Tú le das cuentas a Dios por tus acciones, no por las acciones de ellos. Tú haz lo que Dios. If God told you to go talk to them, you go talk to them. And you let God take care of the seed you sow in their life. Si Dios te dijo que le hables a tus hijos, háblale a tus hijos y deja que Dios se encargue de la semilla que tú plantaste en la vida de ellos. ¿Cuántos dicen amén? So, hermano, if you are discouraged, you need to get up. Si estás desanimado, levántate. Mira, I can't. Te levantas o te levanta Dios. Una de dos. You get up or you want God to get you up. One of the two. Because God will cause something in your life to get you up. Dios va a hacer que algo cause, que algo venga sobre tu vida para que tú te levantes. Because if you have a calling in your life, God is not playing. Si tú tienes un llamado en tu vida, mi hermano, Dios no está jugando. God called you for such a time as this. Dios te ha llamado para un tiempo como este. What are you going to do? Continue to cry, or are you going to get up and walk? Vamos a llorar, vamos a continuar, vamos a caminar. Dios tiene grandes cosas. Dios tiene un llamado. God has a calling, God has a plan and a purpose. Get up. Get up. Somebody calls you this week and say, you know what? Were you in church Sunday? No. Okay, then get up. Go watch the service. Debe de servicio. Because that word was for you. Si está, si alguien le llama por teléfono que no está aquí, dígale, vaya a ver el servicio del domingo. Porque usted necesita oír esa palabra para que se levante. So that you can get up. Don't tell me your problem. Tell me what you're going to do. No me diga su problema. Dígame qué es lo que va a hacer. El problema puede ser resuelto. Problem to be resolved. What are you going to do after God resolves the problem? ¿Qué es lo que vas a hacer cuando Dios resuelva el problema? Get up as if the problem has already been resolved. Levántate como que el problema ya ha sido resolvido. That's why he said to call those things that are not as though they are. Por eso dice que llame las cosas que no son como si ya lo son. ¿Cuántos dicen amén? Señor, estoy pasando por ese problema, pero yo sé que tú ya te encargaste, así es que yo voy a seguir con el llamado. God, I'm going through this problem, but you're already going to take care of it. So I'm going to continue to do what you call me to do. Say amen, somebody. Thank you. Thank you.